We're making spring rolls today in the News 9 kitchen. We're joined by Peter Raven. He's from the Nashua Country Club. We should mention that the Nashua Country Club, they do weddings and that sort of thing, but you're just open, really, for people that belong there.
Yes.
But you're making your special spring rolls, and you start off with your sauce. So what do you put in that?
We're making a little sweet or soy sauce, dipping sauce, soy sauce, rice wine vinegar, scallions, a little garlic chili sauce.
And is that something you get at the Asian markets?
Yeah, I picked this up at the Saigon Asian Market in Nashua.
Okay.
A little brown sugar. Some white sesame seeds. And black sesame seeds. And a little bit of garlic.
And there you have it. And that's the special
and
sauce.
And some ginger. I can't forget the ginger.
Oh, yeah. You need that.
And just give it a little stir. If you want a little more spicy, you can add a little more of the garlic chili sauce.
Mm-hmm.
I'll add that right to my bowl here.
All right. And so that's the great sauce that you serve with it. And now, these are not the fried spring rolls. These are the ones
These are fresh spring rolls made from rice paper. I picked this up at the Saigon Market as well.
All right.
And you want to let that sit in the water for about 7 to 10 seconds.
And that's it. Just so that it gets
a little, yeah, just so that it gets a little soft. And then allows you to roll up the ingredients. I have scallions, summer squash, zucchini, carrots, enoki mushrooms, red peppers, and then some shrimp. I've also done some with roast beef and lobster as well.
Oh, wow. So you can really throw anything in there. And are they easy to work with?
They are, as long as they're not cracked. You don't want to work with one that's cracked.
Okay, because it'll just rip, is that right?
Right, it'll just rip. And just take whatever you feel like. If you want to put some shiitake mushrooms or some shrimp or lobster or anything like that. Can definitely go ahead and put that right in there.
All right.
Could actually take a little bit of the sauce as well.
And throw it in.
Yeah, basically you just roll it up, tuck it in.
And it's so much better for you.
Yeah, it's nice and healthy.
Yeah.
You know, if you use low-sodium soy sauce as well, that adds a little more of a health component.
Now, if you make these at home, should you chill them
You can. You just eat them right away.
Or just eat them right away.
Just eat them right away. They do tend to get a little bit sticky once they sit for a little while, so you do want to make them as close to presentation as possible.
Mm-hmm.
That way they don't get soggy and get too sticky, and then you can't pick them up.
Right, right.
And then enjoy it with the soy sauce and maybe some wasabi peas. We all like those.
Oh, yeah, they're delicious.
So, excellent.
All right, Peter, thanks so much for coming
Absolutely.
In.
Thank
we appreciate
you.
It, and we'll be right back.